God be the glory for everything he's done. And I think that at an hour like this, what a privilege it is and what a blessing it is to be able to say, God be the glory.
Amen.
For the life of this beloved soul who fought a good fight, who have kept the faith. And now it's finished.
Amen.
It's over. God bless you with these daughters, sisters, and brothers, and all the rest of y'all. Thank God that y'all knew and loved and married Cobb. Sweet soul, sweet spirit. I got to try to sing a little song. Then I won't have a word to say. But I think this song bespeaks Mary Cobb's life. I've had some good days. I've had some years to behind me. I've even had some weary days. And lonely nights. But when I look around.
All right.
And I think things over. All of my good days out the way.
Thank you.
in me. God is in me. God is in me. God is with me. God is with me. God is with me. God works through me. God works through me. God works through me. God is for me. God is for me. God is for me. God is for me. And where God is, there can be no failures. No failures. Amen. Thank God for this family. I visited both of these daughters in their home. They had a great mama that taught them how to keep a house. Both the houses were good and clean and welcoming. I have a back pain today. I don't know what happened, so I'm all right. But every now and then a sharp pain running across my back, so I'm all right. I can't move too good, but I still want to be here.
Oh, that's right. Yeah. I still want to be here.
God give me strength. I wanted to talk today about the last move. The last move right now. I asked Sherry, how many times did Sister Bush move? I know she's down in Mississippi. I visited Mississippi 3 times, and I always found her happy to see me. She acted like she knew me. Yeah, and I think she did. You don't know about these folks. You don't know about these folks, and you don't know how God can relate with them, and they may be happy to see it, and they may not be able to express that they're happy to see it, but they're happy to see it. And so I said, she moved from Mississippi. She had folks in Mississippi. She moved to Illinois. And she had some folks there, and she came to Indianapolis. Who came here first? Who came here? Did Bernice come here first? Or did Mary come here first? Said Mama came here first. And she would happen to come here. And she lived a beautiful life. Life can be beautiful. Did y'all know that? If you live it right, life can be beautiful. Life can be wholesome. You can have some friends in life if you. I visited last night for 2 hours with Sister Georgia Boone. And she's in another situation. She has nobody. She got to go back to Virginia because she only has some nieces over there. She had no sisters, no brothers, no daughters, no sons. She got to go home because she's old. She's 91, and all of us going to get old. I'm old. I'm 88. I'm old. But I got some children. Georgia has no children. Mary has some children that she taught and loved and trained and walked before them.
Yes, sir.
As a mother ought to walk. So I want to talk about the last move. Because all of us come to a place that in this life, we're going to have to check out.
All right.
Do y'all know that? Some of y'all live like you ain't going to have to check out. But we're going to have to move from this place to a home that God has prepared just over in glory land, where the saints next to God shall dwell. And so I thought that we'd talk a little bit about the last move.
All right.
Now we know that if this earthly tent we live in is destroyed, we have a building.
Right.
Of God. An eternal house in heaven. Mm-hmm. Not built by human hand.
Mm-hmm. Right.
2 Corinthians, the 5th chapter, and the 1st verse. Now we know. Now you gotta be particular that you gotta find out who we are.
Right.
We are not everybody. It may not be everybody in here.
That's right.
Some of you may not know who we talk about when we talk about we know. We that believe in God. We that believe that he said one day, I'm going away to prepare a place for you. We know that this world is not our home. We're just traveling through here. Our treasures, we send up timber. Y'all, we used to sing that, y'all don't sing that no more. But we send up some timber every day, some tuba boards.
Right.
To build us a mansion. And according to the works that you do down here, it's really how big your mansion is going to be.
Right.
And some of you ain't seen up nothing yet. But you can start today looking at the life of this beloved soul.
That's right.
Who loved life. Who lived the life she loved. Who walked the talk. Talked the talk. Mary Cobb was a unique person. She didn't act like she was 95. I thought she was sweet 16. She had not a grumpy spirit. She had a glowing spirit. She had a loving spirit. She had a kind spirit. And so she was able to go from place to place. She wanted to be in Mississippi, she'd go to Mississippi.
All right.
Yeah, I don't know where you live. Where she go wherever she wanted to go. Because she found some loving folks that she had treated right. She trained the children right. She trained the sisters right. I think she made Bernice behave. And so when she wanted to move to Indianapolis, she came here and she found love here. She found a church here. She found joy here. And we really could have this service and name it a service for darkers, because she was a darker. She was the darker. Y'all don't know. Y'all don't come to Sunday school, so y'all don't know darkers. Darkers was the woman, and I don't want to do that miracle today. Darkers was the woman that did so much good. And she made so many tinkers for other folks. And she did some things for folks until that when she died, they had a display room of all the things that she had sold. Oh, y'all don't understand me. And all the things she made, they want to put them on display. And when the Apostle Paul came back, he looked at all that stuff that Dorcas had done. He said, I don't think she ought to die right now. And so Apostle Paul decided to call him back. Hey, I don't know if anybody that you lived around, some folks in your home, your brothers and your sisters, your cousins, your aunts, you don't want to be bothered with them no more, but we wouldn't mind being bothered with Mary. Right. We didn't mind taking care of Mary because she took care of so many other things in her lifetime. So we know that this world is not our home and we just pass it through. And when this earthly tent, and you notice Paul here, he said he calls this body of ours a tent. Not a building. You live in, this is just a tent. A tent is something temporary.
Right.
It wasn't built for eternity.
Right, right.
It was just built for 95 years.
Right, right, right.
Some of us don't get to be 95. Some of us, when they shoot folks around here, you just live as you live, you may be cut off, train up a child in the way he should go, so when he can get old. If you obey your father and mother, your days may be longer.
Yeah, yeah.
Maybe longer. Mary must have been a good child. Mm-hmm. Lord, she outlived all of her mourners. They're gone over. They have moved on. And now, because her tent has sprung a leak, it can't stand on. It can't stand no more wind. Can't stand no more storms. Can't go through so much heat anymore. When this earthly tent that we live in be destroyed, it's got to be taken down.
Right.
Oh, Lord. You know, it's a job when you take down a household. And y'all notice when you got to move out. Oh, so much stuff that we done stored up in these tents of ours, but you gotta leave these things.
Yeah.
And it's mighty good to know that you've got some place to move and somebody to receive you and somebody to welcome you and somebody to greet you. Well, angels, get my mansion ready. And ring. Mary said, because I'm coming home. So though this earthly house be destroyed, we have a building from God that is eternal.
Right.
Is not temporary. These tents are temporary. Y'all understand me? Y'all think y'all got, I mean, the days of our years may be 80 and 10, but that's just temporary.
Right, right.
I mean, you can drink all you want to drink, act a fool all you want, or you living in a temporary house. One of these days, you're going to be caught up and you're going to be called.
Yeah, right.
From this temporary house, and then where are you going to move? Is anybody going to know you over in glory land? Some folks don't get tired of you down here. We didn't get tired of Mary. You gotta move.
Yeah. Me?
from a temporary house into an eternal building. In heaven.
All right.
That's where we're going. We're going, not she's already gone. We gonna deposit her here in Lincoln Garden, but she's not in Lincoln Garden.
Right.
She won't be there. She moved into the sky. In fact, all thing I know for certain is that absent from this body. Yeah. Hallelujah.
Right.
I wish I could put her in heaven right now, but I don't know if she's in heaven right now. I don't know. God must have another keeping place. For she is, wherever the Lord is, she's with the Lord.
Right.
And wherever the Lord is, in heaven.
All right.
For I'm persuaded. I'm convinced. I've been made sure that death nor life nor angels. I'm convinced that principalities, nor demons, nor things present,
yes, sir,
nor things to come, I'm persuaded that the future, with whatever power it brings, neither height,
yes, sir,
nor depth, nor any other creature, will be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus, our Lord. She moved on to be with the Lord.
Yes, sir.
And happy are the saints that move from this troubled, benign world to go to my Father's house, where everything is all right. In my Father's house. In my Father's house. In my Father's house. So, I thank God for the life. For she shall rest from her labors.
Amen. Amen.
And her works. Yeah. And just for a moment, reminisce on some of the things that she meant to you in this life.
Amen.
Lord, think about things that are lovely, just, and pure. And keep your mind. Don't think about the disease that attached to the body. Because she withstood that. So the suffering of this present time, it ain't long. Because when you think about what God has prepared, you think about what God has prepared, you don't mind enduring hardships.
Right.
Like a good soldier. So long, Sister Mary, you bless my life. You touch my life. And I thank God that you touch many more lives as you move and as you transition here on this earth in Mississippi and Illinois and Indiana. Thank God for the fruit of your body that you gave to your daughter, and that they can carry on to tradition that their mother put in them that there is a God. And be certain that when it comes your time to transition out of this world, that you got a place to go. And that somebody is waiting to welcome you when you get there. Somebody say goodbye, but on the other hand, somebody say hello.
That's right.
And can you imagine that great host of, that's in heaven right now, that said hello? Mm-hmm.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. I've been waiting for you. So in this earthly house, be desired. We got another building that's not made by hand.
Right.
But it's made by the hands of the man that says, I'm going away to prepare a place for you. And when I get my place ready for you, I'm coming again to receive you. Oh, God. To have God to send Jesus, who shed his blood down on Calvary's cross, to receive me? He's welcoming me? He loved me so much that he's welcoming me to my new place. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, sir.
Thank you for dying, and thank you for making a place for me. Excuse me, it can be for you too.
Yes, sir.
It's for all of those who love his appearance. It's for all of those who appreciate the fact that he died on Calvary's cross for you. And yes, he died for me. What a wonderful trip that will be. Mary said, I'm ready to go. I'm washed in Calvary's flow. And that will be the last movie. Don't have to move no more. That's to be the last moving for America. God bless you. And we say, so long. Old folks, it's been good to know you. It's been good to know you.